Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel and I hope you all are doing well, great and happy and healthy. So let's see what all made it to my monthly favorites because I have quite some products to show you guys, not much, but then let's straight away jump right into it. So first, this time I'm going to show you all the skincare and then we'll jump right into the makeup. So apparently I don't have too much of makeup. I have a lot of skincare this time. So the first item which I wanted to show you from the longest time actually, and I was just waiting for this monthly favorites to come, was this Wheat Full Body Waxing Kit in the dry skin variant. Now guys, this is bomb degree. Like, I don't know, people's thought may change or variate than me, or people would not say that no, this is not good, but for me this works amazing. Like, I wear dresses, like not too much of knee length, my dresses are generally of a midi length, so but I want to have waxed legs, so I absolutely love this concept. And from the time I've got this box, I don't think so I have gone for my leg waxing, for that matter even my hand waxing, because I just use these strips. It's only obviously for underarm waxing, for your bikini waxing, all that you have to go to the parlor. But then for my leg and my hand waxing, I'm not gone, and I think now I should stop using this. But then this is quite handy, like if I'm traveling, like I've gone to Rishikesh, you would have already seen my Rishikesh vlog, there I was wearing dresses, so this was quite quick, like just put, and it's not painful. You'll get used to it. One first time you may feel okay, oh my god, it's gonna pain, but then I think after the first time, the second time you'll be all okay with it. So this is really nice and this will cost you 190 rupees only. Next up is a skincare product. It's an anti-wrinkle cream by Himalaya, and I've already done a full review with comparison video with the Garnier one, so I will link down that video also in my description, or maybe I'll put it here or here, I'm always confused. So this is a palm riggedy anti-wrinkle. You can see I've been using today also, I've been wearing under my makeup. This is so good. I like it. Like the weather has just started, it started raining a little slowly, like in Delhi it's very slow, it's way late I feel, but then this is working really well and I see myself using this more, and I have already bought the second bottle, already repurchased. It's amazing, it's really nice, it's non-sticky, it's not thick, it's not heavy for my skin, it doesn't clog my pores. So I want something like that for my skincare because I'm an oily girl, I'm a combination to oily, I'm an acne prone, so this works wonderful. Next up is a hair care product. This is the Livon Serum Vitamin E Control Fizz Ease Out Tangle Reduce Breakages. Now, from the time I started using this, I really like my hair. Secondly, I have a terrible hair fall in Delhi. I don't know. I never had hair fall in my life. Even during my pregnancy, after my delivery, I had it like for 2.5 months and then I stopped because it's like, it happens with everyone. So this has come to a rescue, and considerably I feel the shine has come back to my hair. Secondly, the fall is a little reduced. I do feel that. It may be because I'm using some other new hair products also, which I will be updating you soon with a new hair care routine. But on and all, this as a serum works really well. It really gives that shine because people have been asking me, what are you doing to your hair? So I do say that this is one of the steps which I'm doing and it's working out well. Hands down, Livon, I was not expecting this out of you, but then this is working well. Next is an expensive skincare. Sorry guys, I had to include this because this is really working well for me. This is the Estee Lauder Idealist Pore Minimizer. Now I highly recommend to people who have huge pores and who wants to shrink their pores. Now I will not guarantee this to you that it is going to reduce or remove your pores, but during the certain usages you will see a difference in your skin. You will feel that your pores have shrunken, but then obviously things like these just don't go away. Maybe it may go, but then this has been working good for me more than ANR. I feel if anything in future I would invest my money on would be this Estee Lauder Pore Minimizer more than ANR, because This is good because this is cream based. This doesn't dry out my skin. So wonderful, hands down, amazing. You get only one size as much as I know, and or two sizes. As much as I know, you get only one size in this. I will link it down in my description, but then this is Bomb Diggity. Next is a scent which I have been using the most, and it's about to get over, so I just kept a little bit for you to see. This is the Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue Perfume. This is Eau de Toilette. Now, Eau de Toilette means, guys, it has a water base, because a lot of people have a confusion. What is Eau de Toilette and Eau de Perfume, something like that. So the perfume one has oil in it and this one has water in it. So people who doesn't like too much happening with the fragrance on their body, you should definitely go for the toilet one, because that is like more on a lighter version and it doesn't cling on to your clothes also. So after a wash you may not see the or may not feel the scent of your perfume. So this one is really nice, really light, really fresh fragrance, and you can see it's only this much left. And I'm going to finish it off like another 2 days. So it's just one of my favorites. And I'm not going to repurchase it because I already have a lot of perfume. So I have many other on my wishlist. You would have already seen my wishlist. I want to buy those. Okay, saying that, let's move on to the second last skincare is the Herb Day Cleansing Cream Aloe by Facial. Oh my God. Where was I and why I never picked up this? But that thanks to the travel kit, I got this and I'm obsessed with it. More than my Clinique Take the Day Off, I have been using this a lot. Like, you can see it, I'll show you. You can see the tub is almost half. I have been just digging in this. I just used this to remove my makeup because this is something which is so good for me, because what happens, you know, now I'm filming, my baby is awake, he's just looking at me quietly because he's not feeling well also. But there are days when he's very active and I have to just remove my makeup and I cannot just wash my face immediately because he needs some attention from me. So this doesn't dry out my skin because it has oils in it and it really gives me that hydration. So I can still survive and, you know, do my other works and then go and do my remaining skincare. But then this one, hands down, I love it. So I will be repurchasing this, but I will be repurchasing the travel kit only because I need the pouch. And secondly, the other stuff which you get in the green one is amazing. Like, I will place the picture here somewhere, you can see which one I'm talking about. But then this kit you should buy. I have got the other kits also. I bought the travel kit also, but then I've got the working women's kit also. But I feel out of all the three, this works best for me. I loved it. Last but not the least, we are down to some interesting sheet mask. Now, I have been sheet masking a lot. Past 6 months, I have been sheet masking a lot. And earlier, I used to just buy and use it not too often. But nowadays, weekly, at least twice, I use it. And I have done dedicated videos to a lot of dedicated brand sheet masks on my Instagram. So you can go ahead and watch there how they work on me. I've written a little bit about them. But then, these are the sheet masks I swear by, and I think this will work for anyone. So if you are in a doubt and if you want any specific sheet masks, you can go ahead and grab these. So the three masks which I have been using the most is the Deer Packer ones. The Deer Packer Lab Collection masks are the best to buy. So the one I use the most is the anti-firming and anti-aging. The second one I use the most is the anti-pollution clearing. And the third one is the brightening. Now, brightening is the not the most used mask by me because at times I need brightening, but I don't need brightening as such every time I use a mask. My purpose of using a mask is that it should do something to my skin. It should give some nourishment to my skin. So that nourishment I get from these two. So all in all, these three masks I use the most, and I was very skeptical when I bought them, but then from the time, like past 3-4 months, I've been buying Deer Packer masks and they're so good, on point, very good quality. I was not expecting this, but then they are really good. The Lab Collection one. The next two masks which I like using from the face shop is the solution mask. The solution mask in the pore care face mask, and the second one is the firming face mask. These two I like the more. There is one more which I like, which I don't have it currently to show you guys because it's over. So these are the two masks I love the most. I highly recommend grab the solution mask if you're into your aging. Invest a little extra money on your skincare. I think you're not going to regret it because everybody is going to get older. It's just that we don't want to see with ourselves with wrinkles and fine lines so early, so you can just delay the process. So those were my monthly skincare favorites. Let's jump on to some exciting makeup. So the first makeup product which I have been using the most this month was Pro Conceal by LA Girl in the shade medium beige and nude, specifically the shade nude. Why I've kept it together so that you can see the shade difference. The nude one, basically this one, is for color correcting. So if you don't have dark circles and don't have too much of pigmentation, but you just need to hide your blemishes or hairline or hair, basically facial hairs, or just like that, like a very basic minimalistic correcting, and it is not supposed to be too dark in shade, so there you can go for the peach one. But the shade here is mentioned nude, I don't know why, but I ordered peach, but it looks like peach only. You can see it looks peach only. So if you're a person who don't need too much correcting, I think this is the shade you can go for. And today also I have done it. Like nowadays I'm all about concealers. I just love these two concealers, hands down, one of the best. The next two products are the face products which I have been using the most, and today I'm wearing it. Most of the makeup what I'm going to show you, mostly everything I show you today in makeup, I'm wearing it on my face. So this is the Flower Beauty blush in the shade Wild Rose. Girls, if you're a dry skin, I highly suggest you try Flower Beauty blushes. They may not flake you out and they may not dry you out, because yes, dry skin ladies do suffer, or a lot of you ask me also, like, you know, a powdered brush flakes out at times or give you a more patchy effect. But then I think Flower Beauty one would not give you that effect because it's a little velvety in texture. I don't know, at least you can see it in the pan. And some of you have a doubt, does it have shimmer? No, it doesn't have any kind of shimmer. At least this particular shade doesn't have it. I don't know about the others, but this one is Bomb Diggity. I think it will complement most of the Indian skin tones because it's very, very cool tone. Like, it's not warmer, it's not cooler, it's somewhere in between. I'm wearing it today. It's very subtle. Like, I wanted something like this. And practically speaking, I've been wearing this only from the time I've got it. So, amazing, amazing. Currently, Nykaa has amazing sale on Flower Beauty, and you can get an additional 5% using the coupon code I will mention in my description. It is valid only till month end, so grab if you want to grab one. Next is the highlighter palette, duo palette by e.l.f. Cosmetics, which I've been obsessing over a lot. Now, initially when I bought this highlighter palette, I was not quite a big fan of it. Practically speaking, I was like, I just wasted my 600 rupees. But then now, I'm all about this highlighter. You can see my highlight. But this is more of a skin-like highlighter, which you can build it to another level if you know how to use it. Point is, whenever you mix both the shades, they work perfect. But when you use it separately, they don't actually show up a lot. So the best usage or the best way to use this palette is to mix both the shades and use it. You will get the result. If you're a person who likes too much highlight, then don't buy this. But if you're a person like me who likes subtleness, like you can see my nose, you just saw my face. So it is perfect for me. Something which is not showing too much, but it is there. So I absolutely love and absolutely recommend this highlighter to people who are looking out for something very inexpensive, but very good. Next is a setting spray, which I've been using and I'm wearing it today also, is the NYX Dewy Finish. Now, I never thought I would like this fixer because I was always in double minds to buy it or not. But then when I received it and I started using it, and I absolutely fall in love with it. I'm an oily girl person. I generally will not buy a dewy finish setting spray, but I liked this one apparently because it doesn't damage my makeup, I would say it doesn't give me that very oiliness on my face. Instead, it's just giving me a subtle glow. You can see that. it's really nice. Now, I've been wearing this makeup past 2 hours because it never happens that I wear a makeup and then suddenly I just will just sit and film a video because I have a baby. So I have to take care of him in between. It's already 2 hours and you know, my makeup is still on point and it gives a very nice glow to my face. So absolutely, absolutely in love with it. And I will repurchase this whenever it gets over. It's really inexpensive and really good. Like, I never thought I would ever like a dewy finish setting spray. By using this, I am all up for some dewy finish foundation. So soon I will be grabbing one of the dewy finishes I've been eyeing. So that wonderful, that setting spray has worked on my face. Next are the two eye products which are very good and I think you should definitely buy if you can. So the first one is the L'Oreal Super Liner. This is easily available on Nykaa and wait for a good discount because on Nykaa there are days when you get L'Oreal products flat 500, that day you buy this because I think this is a 900 something. It's expensive, but today's Kajal and today's liner is this baby. It's very comfortable. The felt lip liner is so good. Why I like it so much? I have so many liners, but why this one specifically? Because this works on my any kind of shimmers, any kind of mattes, anything. But there are certain liners which may not give you the liner effect if you apply it on the shimmers, or your liner may just dry out in between when you're applying. So that happens with a lot of my liners, but this one, it's a fixer. I blindly use this. So when I'm traveling, I know what to travel with, this one. So I am going to repurchase this one. This is amazing. Absolutely in love with it. The next eye product is the mascara. So this is the ColourPop Voluminizing Mascara. Again, from the time I've got it, I think I've been using this one a lot. Other than my Tarte one, the Maybelline one, I use this the most. Like, this is my go-to. The days when I don't wear makeup, I think this mascara does the magic for my eyes. Like, I don't wear eyeshadows all the time. Full-on makeup I don't do. I go very minimalistic on my normal days. So this mascara is so good. Just uplifts the lashes. Now, I'm not a person who wears a lot of falsies. I'm a very occasional falsie wearer. So this is amazing. Now, people who don't wear falsies are always on lookout of a good mascara. So this is one of those mascaras which works so perfect for me. You can see my lashes. So I really like it. I love it. And I've got a blue shade also. You see my love for this mascara. I've got a blue and I'm going to buy yellow, white, whatnot. Suggest me some good colors. I'll buy it. Okay. Second last product of the makeup item is the two eyeshadow, are the two eyeshadow palettes. The one is the Give It To Me Straight by ColourPop. Today I'm wearing the two shimmers. I'm not wearing two shimmers only, I'm wearing a lot of shades. I'll tell you what all shades I'm wearing. So I'm wearing these two. This I'm wearing on my inner corners and my brow bone, this in on my lids. Then I'm wearing this shimmer on the outer corner, a little bit outer, and then I'm wearing this matte just to merge it at the end, just blend the harsh lines. And this I'm wearing this matte again on my lower lash line. So if you are in a doubt and you people keep asking me what ColourPop palette to buy this one. See, there are many good palettes. Like, I think ColourPop launches always good palettes only. There's nothing wrong with their palettes. The pigmentation is on point. The shimmers are so good. Yes, recently I've seen some of the reviews on some other channels that some of their palettes, the pigmentation is a little off. Not the mattes, the shimmers. But I don't have those palettes, so I cannot comment on them because I've not used it personally. But this one is their older baby and it's amazing. Just buy it. If you are in any doubt, buy this one. If you don't want to buy Yes Please, because Yes Please has some bolder shades, but this one I feel will suffice anyone. Like, anybody would be happy to use this palette and have this palette because I just give you a life swatch. You must be thinking she's talking way too much about the palette. These are the two shimmers I've applied. You look at the blindness. You can use this palette as a multi-purpose. You can use this shimmer for your highlight. You can see my inner corner. It's so blinding. That good this palette is. Like, hands down. Get it. Don't get it now. I would suggest you wait for November and December because Colourpop comes with flat 50% off offer also. That time you can grab as many palettes you want to. And if you want me to do an updated Colourpop worth buying palette, do let me know. I've already done one. That I will link it down in my description. But I would like to do an updated one. If you want me to do it, I'll do it. There you can decide what all palettes you want to buy. So save some money for November and December. Next is another interesting palette from the time. It's already 2 months and I have been, it's not already 2 months, it's going to be 1.5 months. From the time I've got it, I have been using this religiously. It's my NYX Cosmetic Perfect Filter Rustic Antique Palette. So today also I'm wearing it. So the two shades I'm wearing from this palette today are this corner one. This is the ultra satin finish, which it's on my outer corner. Basically the first gray shade I used it. For the base I used this. First I used this shade, then I went in with this shade, and then when I went in with this shade to just deepen up my crease. The Colourpop matte for shadow, I have used it on my lower lash line and just to merge my shimmers. So basically my mattes have come from here, the shimmers have come from there. So absolutely love this palette. Again, wonderful palette. I highly suggest you if you are in a doubt. Like, you know, I never thought this palette would work so good. So I'm going to swatch one shimmer and one matte for you so that you know what I'm talking about. This is one swipe. This is one swipe. Like I never had such good experience with NYX palettes, practically speaking. But because I was not quite a big fan of NYX Ultimate palettes, I have disposed them. But I never liked them so much because I felt the pigmentation was off. But here you're getting very much good quality pigmented shadows. This is for $1599, but NYX also keeps running discounts, so just grab it when there's a discount. I would not suggest you to go buy in full price. If you can, then just go ahead buy. I will leave this link in my description. But this is an amazing palette if you're looking for a warm palette. Amazing buy. You can blindly buy it. And I have done a full swatch and some 2-3 looks on my Instagram. So you can go ahead, follow me on Instagram @BronzingGeek. Because I do a lot on my Instagram also. Oh, finally, we are down to our final segment, that is lipsticks. So I have 4 lipsticks to show. Actually, I had one more lipstick to show you guys, but I thought, control, I'll show you next month. Because I'm just started using them, so it's way too early to fit those lipsticks here. So these are the 4 lipsticks which I'm wearing the most. The one of them I'm wearing now is the PAC Cosmetic Sweet Sensation lipstick. I've done a full review on these also. Now look at the shade. This is one of the unique shades I have in my collection. I don't have something like this, and PAC does some amazing shades, I must tell you guys. So this is the shade #Savage. Oh my god, see the outer packaging doesn't match my lipstick. This is what I was trying to tell you in my haul, my review video, that the packaging doesn't match the lipstick which is inside. So don't be shocked if you get the lipstick and you're like, oh my god, did I really just order 2 same shades? So this is like amazing. #Savage, amazing, amazing shade. And #Savage can be a very good bold shade for my deeper skin girls, because I feel you should not be fear or tense to wear some bolder shades, because this can really uplift your look, I'm telling you. Like, I'm a person who like warm tones. I like, for that matter, I like warm skin, because, you know, everything lays so well on a warm skin, I feel. And everything just looks skin-like. Like, that's my personal opinion. But this shade is bomb diggity. Just buy, even if you are a deeper skin tone person, you will like it. Like, if you're a girl who doesn't like bolder shade, then I would not recommend you to buy if you're a deeper skin tone person. But then, this is an amazing shade. You cannot miss it. Grab it. Okay, saying that, enough of PAC. Let's move on to another lipstick which I've been enjoying the most. It's the Flower Beauty one. This is an amazing lipstick. Again, I'll swatch this lipstick for you. So this is the Flower Beauty one. I'll just swatch it. This is one swipe. You don't need another dip when you're applying this lipstick, and secondly, it's so pigmented. You see the pigmentation? You don't need a lip liner also for this lipstick for that matter. And secondly, it's matte, but it's non-drying matte. It's ultra satin finish. If you have used ColourPop Ultra Satin, I feel this and that formula is very close. Instead, the Flower Beauty one is more pigmented, I would say. It's thick. It's very thick. So it's very good. It's the shade Rose Wood, one of my favorite shades nowadays. Like, any girl would like to have a nice, wonderful nude. So it's nice. Like, if, like in bottle, if you see, you may feel it may wash out. Yes, it may wash out the deepest skin tone. So I would not suggest you to go for this shade. Go for Marlet Kiss. That's a nice shade again. But this one is an amazing, like if you're a deeper, if you are my skin tone, a lighter skin tone, this will complement you hands down. Get this shade. And you can get, and these lipsticks are on discount. These are for $965. And currently you're getting these lipsticks for $700 something, and you can get additional 5%. So save some money, get one shade, use it, and do let me know how do you feel about it. Last but not the least are the two lipsticks which I think, okay, let's just get into the lipstick. The first one is the Masaba lipstick, the shade Nibupani. Oh my god. I think this is the most selling shade by in the whole range, the Nibupani shade. Because this is a shade which will complement anyone and everyone. Let's get into the lipstick straight away. So this is the Nibupani shade. Most of you asked me in my review video also, like, will it suit me? Will it complement me? It will complement any skin tone. It's a perfect nude for a very deeper skin tone. It's a very nice nude, like a little deeper nude for a very fair skin tone. For my skin tone, it is in between. So it's nude. Basically, it's a nude for all the skin tone in different ways. It's the undertone basically, which is going to change as per the skin tone. So this is an amazing shade. I suggest from the whole range, if any nude, if you want to buy, you can go for Nibupani. Nibupani is the shade you want to enjoy the most. The Pataka shade I've got, that's a red. Not many people would like that shade. There are other shades also. But Nibupani, I think, is the universal shade from all 12 shades. So I think Nibupani is like a blind spot. Just buy it. Last but not the least is one of my favorites again. And I'm going to buy more shades from this range, is the Creamy Matte Collection by Maybelline. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we neglect certain products. This is the Neglected Baby, which I just bought it. I bought like 1.5 months back, and I have been wearing this shade so much. Oh my god. I will swatch this shade very close to the Nibupani shade just to so that you know how it looks. So this is Touch of Spice. Maybelline Touch of Spice. This is Nibupani. Now the formula for both of them are very close. It's just that Nibupani would feel a little more pigmented or a little more thicker than the Creamy Matte. So if you are not a person who can invest your money on Masaba, then go for Creamy Mattes. They're really good. I love this shade. Oh my god. And I'm eyeing on another shade called Clay Crush, which is again really beautiful. I've seen it in person. I'm just going to buy it. So yeah, these were my monthly favorites. And I hope you all liked everything. Everything, I will mention it in my description for your information. And if you own any of it, do let me know what is your experience. But all in all, I love all these products I showed you today. I've been using them regularly. And one more thing, I just wanted to update you guys that next month you may not see a monthly favorite because I have just got a house. I'm not gone to see the house because I just got it. And maybe I will be moving in that time. So I may just skip the next month monthly favorites. If I get time, definitely I'll film it. But mostly I think I will be missing it. So I just wanted to inform you guys for that. We'll be back soon with something exciting and interesting. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.